Yo, what's going on, my fellow Rich Squad members? LeJune here. Now I'm back with another video. Now, as you guys see, we have some more information that dropped today dealing with Marvel's Avengers. And now this one comes from IGN. Now, in this article, they talked about how Crystal Dynamics were able to fit each hero into this world that they build for Marvel's Avengers. And also, we have some brand new reveals on some new environments that will be in Marvel's Avengers as well. And I will be showing you that. It looks really good. And we also have been hinted on some secret landmarks that we will have to keep an eye out for. So, hey, there's going to be some juicy information that we'll be talking about today. But yeah, before we get into the video, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. Make sure you guys hit that notification bell as well, so you never miss a video on my channel or my streams. And most importantly, hit that like button. Now, without further ado, let's get into this. Let's get to the video. Now, before I get into the video fully, I just have to show you guys the new environments that have been revealed in this recent video that IGN released. Then we're going to get into the video. Just look at these environments. They look so good. Bro, did y'all see those environments though? I can't even lie, they really look fire. Like, just look at them. Now, just imagine what this looks like on the PS5 when we get the high performance mode and the high graphics mode with the 4K resolution of 60 frames. Just imagine what that's gonna look like. It's gonna look amazing. I'm calling it now. Not to say for the ones that, you know, that one that really sticks out to me is the one with the forest with has the fog in it with the sunrise coming through it, especially coming through the trees as well. That looks amazing. I cannot wait to see what it looks like on the PS5. But you know, enough of me fanboying over, you know, the environments and stuff, even though they do look cool. You know, let me know in the comments which one looks dope to you and why. But hey, let's get into this article. Now, in the IGN article, they interviewed the art director of Marvel's Avengers. His name is Bernak Adams. Now, it goes on to state in this article that Adams explains to us, particularly when it comes to author campaign missions, the team strives to make sure that every level work well for the hero and heroes that will be present in these missions. Now, Adam goes on to state that each space and interior and exterior was designed for all the heroes to utilize their specific skill sets. With a character as large as Hulk, the sets need to remain open and able to accumulate his larger than life moves, and still let the heroes like Black Widow, Ms. Marvel use their combat and traversal mechanics appropriately. And I like the way he explained this because, you know, with Hulk being on another level compared to Black Widow and Ms. Marvel, you may be thinking like, how is this, you know, how is Hulk, you know, as powerful as he is in the probably in the game, how is he going to fit, how is Ms. Marvel and Black Widow going to fit in this? Now, they said, I like the way they did this because they said each space and interior and exterior was designed for all the characters to utilize their specific skill sets. So the way they have the map or the hub world, I guess you could say, is built for these characters to really go all out. And they have some more information about that later that we'll be talking about, which he dropped a bomb on. I cannot wait to explain this. But I like the way he explained this because, you know, some people, as I stated, you know, they've been wondering, like, how this is going to work, you know, with Hulk being Hulk and, you know, Captain Marvel. I mean, not say Captain Marvel, Ms. Marvel being Ms. Marvel and Black Widow being Black Widow. So I'm glad he explained this for people so, you know, it could really, like, settle people if they was wondering, like, how are these next level heroes going to work with, you know, some of the heroes that, like, don't have powers like Black Widow. So I'm glad he explained that. But, hey, we finna get into the bomb right here that Adams dropped. I cannot wait to explain this. But hey, let's get into it. Now, for this part of the article, it goes on to talk about Warzone missions. Now, as you guys know, with Warzone missions is where a player can choose whichever hero they want to play as. Now, that both means the team needed to make spaces that allowed every hero to shine, where we're also still fun regardless of what hero a player chooses. Now, Adam goes on to state that having enough open space for heroes to move comes with its difficulties. Environment sets must have a size and shape that balances possibilities and character metrics, which was a substantial challenge. We never wanted to restrict any of the heroes from feeling mighty and powerful, so the environment designs are built for the brutal destruction and to lend players the opportunity to fulfill the fantasy of being their favorite hero no matter the location. Now, that is pretty dope. I like the way they really did that one. That the fact that they don't limit you or what you can you to fulfill your character possibilities and everything. I love that type of stuff. I love to hear that because, say for instance, you know, we're in like a, say like it's a map design, you know, small and everything, you could still go out all out there like how you want to play. You can still, there's no restrictions or nothing. You can still play it how you want to play and not hold back, honestly. And I like that type of stuff because, say like, you know, there's some type of game, there's some games that limit you on some specific missions that like really hold you back. And I don't like that. And the fact that they just said it clearly here that they don't want to hold you back. Like, if you want to be that hero, you're going to be that hero. And I love that. I love that type of stuff dearly. And the fact that they said, you know, the environment designs are built for brutal destruction. Does that mean that, you know, we can, you know, break things? You know, just break a couple things? You know, that would be dope. I ain't gonna lie. You know, to have it as, you know, playing as Hulk. And I noticed that as with Hulk today. When they released the brand new things about him, when he was damaging the ground and everything, those environment, those effects that he had on the environment, on the ground, stayed. Like, they didn't disappear or nothing. They just stayed there. And, like, he hit the wall, he hit the ground and everything. And his attacks still, the effects of the attack still stayed on the ground and the wall. And I like that type of stuff. So, if it's like that, then, bro, I think I gonna lie to you. Imagine if we could just run through a wall with Hulk or something like that. Even though I don't know if it'll happen, it'll just be dope to, you know, dope to see or something. But I think 9 times out of 10, it'll be like we can explode cars and stuff like that, explode boxes and, you know, like flame boxes and everything. So, hey, I'm here for it. I like this type of stuff to hear. I love to hear stuff like this. So it's pretty dope. Now, we can get on to the part when they talk about landmarks. Now, Adam was real brief about when it comes to landmarks. He pointed out things saying there are a number of Marvel landmarks nested in real world locations. Some of the locations have been augmented to fit the story that's in the game, and also the locations Ms. Marvel fans will recognize when you're playing the game. So there'll be some special sites that Ms. Marvel will visit that will be in the game. So hey, for you Ms. Marvel fans, hey, this is for you. And also for the last one, they have this. He says this, keep a sharp eye out. Some landmarks are larger than life. Many are hidden and require attention to detail. So I ain't gonna lie, for you Easter egg hunters and the people, the Hawkeyes out there, hey, find them. Find the hidden ones, bro. We gotta see what they hiding from us. We gotta see this. And the fact that they just really dropped this is really dope. Because we got new environments, we got new details, and the fact that they're just talking about how they don't want to hold people back from playing as the Avengers. You know, you're going to play as the Avengers, you're going to get the full effect of it, and I like that type of stuff. So I'm glad they really did this. It's really cool. I really condemn them for this. It's really nice. And plus, we're getting the World Cup stream tomorrow, too, so that just even adds on to it, bro. We just getting stuff left and right. We can't even handle all of it right now, especially tomorrow, bro. It's going to be litty. As you guys know, I will be live streaming that War Table stream tomorrow too, so you know, be on the lookout for that. But yeah, this is the end of the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed as I enjoyed making this video. Now, I'm sorry if I, you know, voice cracked a little bit. I think I'm losing my voice, which is a bad thing. It really is a bad thing. But without further ado, if you guys go to enjoy the video, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell as well. so you're gonna never miss my videos and my streams. And most importantly, hit that like button. Now, I do have a Discord. It's called Avengers Squad. We cover everything to do with Marvel's Avengers. So if you guys want to join, know how to join, all you gotta do is click the link below. That's all you gotta do. You're in. And also, I do have memberships on my channel. Now, if you guys want to know more information about that, it's in the link below. But I have to give a quick shout out to my members. I have to give a quick shout out to King Trident, A Streets, Trinaeus, Brian, and Hezzy. Shout out to y'all for being memberships on the channel. As I stated before, more information is about that below. But without further ado, it's LeJun here, guys. I hope you guys have a good day. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe, and have a good day. Peace.